Hello friends, so in this video I'll be showing the test for iodide ions. So for that I have a salt, potassium iodide. It is a white crystalline salt. So for that I will take a pinch of salt into a test tube. To this I'll be adding concentrated sulfuric acid. Can see that already there are some fumes evolving. Now just heat this solution. On heating, violet vapors of iodine are evolved. You can also test these vapors with a starch paper. Just bring a starch paper at the mouth of the test tube. Appearance of a blue-black color confirms iodide. You can see violet vapors evolving outside the test tube. And it turns starch iodide paper blue black. These fumes should not be inhaled because iodine fumes are toxic. There is already some iodine condensing on the cooler parts of the test tube, but as the temperature rises, more fumes are coming out of the test tube. You can also add a pinch of manganese dioxide. This will increase the violet vapor of iodine. Over here, I have just added some water and manganese dioxide. And then I will heat it. You can see violet vapor is coming out, which is condensing on the cooler parts of the test tube. On adding manganese dioxide, the violet vapor becomes more clear. Previously, it was reddish brown in color, which was due to the presence of hydroiodic acid, which was also produced. But now, after adding manganese dioxide, all the hydroiodic acid is oxidized to iodine. That's why you see a stream of violet vapor. And this violet vapor also turns starch iodide paper blue black. For the second test for iodide, we need soda extract. So this I have prepared soda extract, and now I will be transferring this into a test tube. Now to this solution, we first need to acidify it with dilute nitric acid. After acidification, now we need to add silver nitrate solution into this. On adding silver nitrate, you can see that there is the formation of a yellow precipitate. It is much yellower than the silver bromide. And also, it is insoluble in ammonium hydroxide. On adding ammonium hydroxide in excess, you can see that the precipitate does not dissolve at all. Even if you add potassium iodide to silver chloride dissolved in ammonium hydroxide, it gives a precipitate of silver iodide. Because silver iodide does not forms complex with ammonia like silver bromide and silver chloride. Take some amount of soda extract to this, add some starch solution. So over here I have some starch solution. Now to this add sodium nitrite. So over here I am adding some sodium nitrite into it. Dissolve it. And then acidify it with hydrochloric acid. On adding hydrochloric acid, a blue-black color indicates the presence of iodide. The final test or the fourth test is the organic layer test, and this is my favorite among all these tests. So for that you need soda extract. Now to this we need to add an organic solvent such as chloroform or carbon tetrachloride. You can see that the chloroform sinks to the bottom and forms a separate organic layer below the solution. Now to this we need to add chlorine water. So for that we need chlorine water. So to prepare it, we take potassium permanganate solution into a test tube. Now to the potassium permanganate solution, add some concentrated hydrochloric acid. Until the color of potassium permanganate lightens. Now our chlorine water is now ready. Add this chlorine water drop wise into this solution. You can see that on adding chlorine water, the solution acquires a brown color. Now just put your thumb at the mouth of the test tube and give it a vigorous shake. You can see that the color of the organic layer that was chloroform is now violet in color. If you add more chlorine water, let's add chlorine water in excess. Now give it a shake. Now you can see that the organic layer is so dark that you can't even see the color, but it's violet in color. दिस इज ड्यू टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ आयोडीन विच इज सॉल्युबल विच इज मच सॉल्युबल इन द ऑर्गेनिक लेयर दैन इन द एक्वस लेयर देयरफॉर इट जस्ट डिजॉल्व्स इन द ऑर्गेनिक लेयर टू गिव अ वायलेट कलर व्हेन यू पास लाइट थ्रू इट यू कैन इजिली सी द कलर So this is the organic layer test for iodide. Like, share, comment and subscribe to my channel. I would like to thank AGA for financial support due to which I am able to create videos which require costly glass equipment like condenser, joints, flasks, etc. If you want me to try advanced synthesis such as Grignard reaction which involve hot laser with magnetic stirrer, three neck flask, different chemicals, etc. You can support me financially through Patreon and PayPal. Links are given in description.